every brother.
Let's call it in the crossfire. Let's call it in the crossfire.
What's up, guys? It's Hayden and
Boo
from
Crossfire Collectibles.
And we have a good haul to show you guys, but before we get started, if you're new or returning to our channel, make sure to leave a giant thumbs up, subscribe, and
give that bell a tickle so you know when we post a new video.
Yep, and here's a little message.
Attention, I'm Sergeant Slaughter from G.I. Joe, the real American hero. My friend over here is going to come in here and tell you all about his show. Come on over. It's called
Crossfire Collectibles.
Crossfire Collectibles. And you better watch, you better listen, and that's in order.
Yeah, so, directly from the Sarge himself. Thanks, Sarge, appreciate it.
Yeah, hope you guys enjoyed that little clip right there. And here is the haul we have to show you guys. There hasn't been that much stuff coming out recently, so there's not that much stuff we can get. They did come out with a new wave of multiverse figures, but we'll get in that later. But before we start off, I want to go ahead and show some stuff that we picked up at our local comic store, Second Chance Toys. Shout out to John. Go check him out. He gave me some free 3D printed stands. Here we have this cool Arashikage one. I'm going to paint it black and then paint the actual Arashikage symbol probably red or white. So that'll look pretty cool. I'll probably put that with my snake eyes. And here we have some normal Joe stands. And I tried these on some Joes and they actually fit really well. Mm-hmm. We actually had three of these, but one of them is on the Zartan. And we did have a Cobra one. That's the one with Cobra Commander.
Oh, yeah. Get the ideas of Cobra.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think we're going to start this off with our Lucy's. Now, we usually do start the videos with Lucy's, but it's a good one, so we'll start off with a good guy. So, I got the FSS Muskrat. Now, he is loose, but he came with the full card back. I picked him up on Joe Trader PX on Facebook. If you're a big G.I. Joe fan, go ahead and check him out. Join in. Great community. Lovely people. So,
stop.
But here's his file card. Muskrat, he's a tough one to come by if you can find him. He has a lot of accessories. I love that with these figures. Some hardly have any. Some come with quite a few. Muskrat, for example, comes with a lot. Here's the figure. And he already has on him, he has his pistol in his holster. He has a knife in his boot. Here's his stand. Codename Muskrat. He comes with a bear trap, a hunting rifle, a pistol grip stock shotgun. If you remember the traditional Real American Hero figures, he came with a machete, and here's his new machete. He's got his sled. It's a lot thicker and heavier than the old one.
What is this
little
doing?
Handle on it. I'll tell you. His silencer, backpack, and his little boony hat. So I'll go ahead and put on him what I can, and he'll explain the next one for you while I do that.
Our next Lucy is the Comic Pack Deep Six. He's pretty cool. Basic, has no leg articulation. His arms can move up and down, and then they do have a little shoulder. Shoulder bend, and then a swivel on his feet. You can take this little bubble off and move his head around or whatever, but he doesn't have that much articulation or whatever. But I do want to compare him to the normal Deep Six. Same mold, same figure, just repainted. This one has a more metallic silver, while this one is like a more older looking gray. They are side by side, same head sculpt, same bubble. I like them both pretty good. They're pretty good figures, but yeah, this Deep Six comes with a code name Deep Six stand, just like this one. He comes with a harpoon gun and a little pump which goes into his back, and if you want to put him in water, press this and he floats. It's pretty cool. And here is his card. You want to pause that and look at that and read it if you want to. But yeah. And then here is the whale, or the shark.
Shark.
I don't know why I said whale. Here's the shark. It's pretty cool. You go ahead and flip this open, and then you'll go ahead and put them inside right there. So yeah, that's pretty cool. You can put them in there. And let's go and look at our next Lucy.
Alright, so while he's opening that, I'll just go ahead and show off Muskrat, kind of geared up. I put his little sled under him, kind of on a stand, gave him his little hat, makes him look like a doof. Backpack on, holding his shotgun and machete. Doesn't have any room to hold the rifle, and the bear trap will go by his feet. So I'll throw the other extra accessories back in a bag and put it alphabetically order in my other bag with his card and all that, and plop him up on a shelf. But there you have it, the G.I. Joe FSS Muskrat.
Okay, so here's Short Fuse. Nothing really special. He does come with a good amount of accessories, though. He comes with a pistol that goes on this little holster on his boot. He comes with a knife that goes in his sheath on his thigh. And then on his vest, he has a little holster with a pistol in there, too. And then he comes with this, too. I don't know if there's like a mortar rocket launcher thing. But it comes with that. So that's pretty cool. You just set it up like that.
This Short Fuse came with the Target exclusive Ultimate Battle Pack. I was fortunate enough to find a couple of them in the wild when they were out, and I picked up a few, but them sets have been long gone, and we needed Short Fuse to put back with the collection to fill in the empty spot. So I picked him up. He's complete, nice condition, good to go, and just welcome back for Short Fuse.
This is his card. Okay, so now we're going to start getting into our more package stuff. So, you want to go ahead and start off with Starscream? Or do you want to wait?
Let's do Legends.
Okay.
Okay, here, I'll explain it. So. I picked these up today. These are street dated for Monday. And today is not Monday, so we actually got them a little early. So, just happened to walk in there and see them, and the way it goes, you know, they cannot sell you street dated items, but I really shouldn't say this on camera, but if you happen to say, well, can I scan one of the other figures that's there, they have plenty of other different legends, that rang up fine, and so that's basically how we got them. So I'll start with Wenwu, and you know this is from Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings. Spoiler alert, so if you don't want to know, you know, fast forward this or whatever. Wenwu, I'll read the back for you just to give you an idea. Wenwu, Shang-Chi's father, Wenwu, is the feared leader of the Ten Rings organization, which has lurked in the shadows of the MCU ever since the very beginning. So that means this is the Mandarin. If you look on his forearms, he actually has 5 rings on each arm. Your typical Mandarin had 5 rings on his hands, but he has them on his forearms, which is kind of cool. We're gonna open them?
Yeah, sure.
Right, we're gonna open them, but he's gonna explain this one first, and we'll let you guys see the first two from the wave. We don't have the whole wave, but we'll explain it later. But before we get to that, we need trusty dusty Kniff.
Okay, so here is Shang-Chi from Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings. I really hope this movie is like a trilogy. I hope it's not just one movie. But here he comes with a cool looking staff. He comes with 4 extra hands. Mr. Hyde's leg. And the figure itself. He looks pretty cool. We might pick up the comic version and go ahead and do a side-by-side comparison if you guys want to see that. They definitely look really different. But I like the casting they went ahead and chose. But, yeah, let's go ahead and open them up. And we are back. We finished taking them out and posing them up. So, here they are. Shang-Chi and Wenwu.
The Mandarin.
Or the Mandarin.
I'll show you the, so here's Mr. Hyde's right arm.
Here's Mr. Hyde's left leg.
some reason, I thought this was like a bird perch that he came with, but it's his cane, Mr. Hyde's cane, but whatever.
Okay, so I went ahead and left the four hands that Shang-Chi actually comes with in there. I do like the kind of like the these hands, but I went ahead and kept these hands on because I have them in a cool stance pose holding the staff, so he's like that. The articulation on him is really well. His legs are really loose. They kind of feel cheap. His legs feel a little cheap to me. I do like the simple design they went with. It does look like they would fit in with Doctor Strange. Mm-hmm. I don't know why, but I like it. Looks really cool.
Yeah.
And
you know, I got to speak a little different because the Wenwu, you know, his torso is a bit loose here. His legs are super stiff, like super stiff. The like skirt kilt type deal he's wearing is pretty tight on him. It is like soft bendable plastic, so that's no big deal. But he's just, there's not much, you know, room for leg posability. He does come with a little hook sword here, you know, there you go, for Cabal customizers or so. But he also came with two additional sets of hands. These were the ones on him, which were just the balled up fists. I took them off. He also comes with these two fists that you could probably make him hold the sword with. But I put these two on him to make him look like he's also about to get ready into a fighting pose with his crouching tiger or whatever pose he's in. But he's really cool. I like him. I think he's awesome. He was actually the first figure of all the Shang-Chi I grabbed. Because I was just like, ooh. And then I forgot what the girl's name was. Xi Ling, I believe. Yeah, she was cool. But I wanted to get these two out of the way because they're assuming going to be the main characters for the movie. You know, Shang-Chi named after him, and then you're going to find out his dad is probably the Mandarin.
So here we have our multiverse figures. We do have Batman Beyond.
And the Batman Death Metal. Dark Knight's Death Metal. Yeah, Dark Knight's Death Metal.
So we have Batman Beyond looking really cool. I'm really excited to go ahead and open this figure up. He's my favorite Batman. I really like Terry McGinnis. But I'm just going to go in straight on and open it in this thing.
All right. And if you remember, I showed this one off in the last video. Did not open. He's still not open. But out on our hunts, I came across the Bat Cycle, the Death Metal Bat Cycle. So since I was like, you know what? I'm just going to grab it and I'm going to put these two together. So you're going to see these opened and together. And while he's doing Batman Beyond, I'm going to do Death Metal Batman. And we'll be right back. All right,
guys. We're back. We went ahead and opened them and posed them all up. But, you want to start off for me?
Yeah, so I'll start. So, here you have the Dark Knight's Death Metal Batman. He's pretty awesome. I love how he's got, like, the Frank Miller-style small ears. He's got his studded, all black, you know, trench coat with the little bat points at the bottom. His, bracers are pretty slick, you know. He's got his scythe, which is awesome. His, like, Reaper scythe. He's got some pretty cool accessories on him. This is the only thing he came with, literally, was the scythe, and he's got his stand.
That'd be cool if we saw that as a Nightmare Batman.
Yeah. There's his card. I'm taking that out. And also the Bat Cycle. There's its card. So, here's the Bat Cycle out of the box. I wasn't really a fan of it, but now looking at it up close, it's pretty neat. Looks like a giant bat skull on the front. And it's pretty cool. It's almost like they took, well, it's McFarlane, so you know, it's got some rubber in it and plastic. It took some, like an idea almost based on Punisher's bike. I did that, but what I'm gonna do is when I display it, I'm gonna have it kind of behind him and Batman will be standing like that with it. Well, probably more like this so you can see the basketball on the bike. So I'll have it something like that.
Okay, so next up is Batman Beyond. As you guys may know, this is Terry McGinnis' Batman after Bruce Wayne retired. Most of you guys might know him from the show. I really like the show. I used to watch it when I was a little bit younger. But basically, pretty much looks the same. In the show, he didn't have his cape on 24/7. I don't know if they can come off. They might be able to, but then you have that giant hole in his back. But on his arms, there's these little pegs that actually kind of fit in. So you have his two little things right here, and then there's a peg right here that actually clips into here. On here, as you guys can see, I have it in there. So that way, if you move his arms, it moves the wings around. But he comes with this cool-looking Batarang that I have him holding up. And I'm going to put him with my Nightwing because I think the Nightwing and the Batman Beyond will fit really well together. And yeah, he looks pretty cool. Almost done my Bat family. I still need to get the Batgirl and a couple others. So I'm going to go ahead.
I did see a Batgirl again today.
So I'm going to go ahead and set him up here. But he also comes with another Batarang holding hand and a normal hand, which has like kind of spiky fingers. And then he comes with another Batarang, really cool looking. And he comes with this Build-A-Figure. You do have to get the other figures to build it, but it's this cool Batman. I don't know what this is, but it's a Batman mixed with the Joker. So, it's pretty cool. Again, I don't know what it's from, but, he does come with these two little tire-looking things that you gotta put inside of his arm right here. So, when you get his other arms, it fits in normally. But, yeah, don't know what this is from. I think it's actually pretty cool-looking. I'm probably gonna finish it, but, yeah, it's pretty cool.
Alright, so next up we have the Studio Series 72. Transformers Bumblebee movie Starscream. Awesome. This thing looks really, really cool. I was really happy to get this. Probably gonna pick up Hot Rod next. But my only issue is that he's a bit small. I like the larger Transformers, you know, because I have like a masterpiece collector. But he is slick. I'm gonna pop him out and show you what's involved while he does this little setup with the Batman. And be right back while he does that.
Okay, so here's the Death Metal Batman on his bike. I put him in this cool looking pose where he's riding, and then he also has his scythe in his hand. Looks pretty cool. I do like the head. Looks really nice. And I think he looks pretty sick on here. So you can just have him chilling like this. Looking really cool. But yeah, so that's the Death Metal Batman and his cycle.
All right, he's gotten to that, so I went ahead and got Starscream in a little pose. He doesn't come with many accessories. He comes with one, like, arm cannon that you can go on, or assuming he can have two. This goes on his hand here. I could probably also go the opposite way, maybe. And nope. All right, so it has to go on this way. But that's all right. So I got him in this little pose, so I'm going to hold him. He isn't going to be transformed, but he does transform into a Cybertronian Seeker, as you can see. And it's got the cool little backdrop, you know. No metal on these figures, of course. You know, they're just Hasbro Studio Series. But I put him on his little backdrop like so. And yeah, so there you have it. Very quick little review for Starscream here. He looks great. He really does. I believe he is the same, pretty much the same mold as, was it Blitzwing? So, that's neat. Same cannon. I think the other cannon is a little different. It attaches at the other end. But, overall it's cool. There's a couple rubber bands I didn't take off, but you can see his other guns on here he has. And no missiles that I see. But still, neat figure. He'll go up with my Starscream display, and happy to have him. Oh. The final classified that we're able to get currently. It's unbelievable because the infantry, he was like he's the last one of the current ones that are out that you can get. Well, besides for the BS, let's bid this guy up to 30 grand for a Major Blood that was circulating on eBay this week. I'm sure some of you collectors have seen it. But, yeah, this is great. I have something to reveal, too, at the end of this video. G.I. Joe related. I actually know something that's being released, but I'll let him go ahead with this.
Okay, so if you guys know, this is the Cobra Trooper, which was a Special Missions Cobra Island Target exclusive, and this is a Cobra Infantry. Two different figures, might be the same sculpt, but they are two different figures, Cobra Trooper, Cobra Infantry. Here they are side by side. They're almost the same. Their paint jobs are a lot different. Yeah. But the Cobra Troopers are, looks like they're white, and then these are probably an African American, some kind of
Middle Eastern.
Yeah, darker type of
Latino, you never know.
Yeah. But that's pretty cool that they're doing different races, so it's not the same. I like that. So I'll put my infantry with my Cobra Trooper, but we're gonna go ahead and open up the infantry. We're gonna go ahead and open up the infantry and the trooper and go ahead and compare them side by side. So I'm gonna open the infantry. My dad's gonna open the trooper.
You guys have seen in past videos, we have opened another Cobra Trooper, but we're gonna pop this one open too, just so you can see an actual comparison of the two figures unboxed.
So we'll be right back when they're done. Here is the Cobra Infantry all taken out and posed up. He comes with two pistols, a knife, and a little assault rifle. I have his one pistol in his front holster, his second pistol in his back holster, and his knife in his front sheath. And then I have him holding his assault rifle, getting ready to shoot. So I went ahead and put him in these awesome stands that John at Second Chance Toys gave us. They fit perfect on him. It's crazy. But, yeah, he looks really cool. I do like him a lot. I don't know if I like him better because I really love the paint job on him. But, I also like the paint job on this. I don't know. I don't know if I like him better. But I do like this one a lot. Might get some, see if there's any extra snipers for him or something. But, pretty cool. I like it. He doesn't come with no goggles, no sniper, and no little armband. But, he does come with the helmet that you can just go and...
Yeah, just give you guys a quick comparison. I was in the middle of posing them, but it's okay. Yeah, so pretty much everything is the same, except, you know, what the same two pistols, knife, machine gun here, a small assault rifle, whatever.
It's a Nerf gun.
Yeah, it's a Nerf gun. But the trooper has goggles. He has his arm piece. And
sniper rifle.
Oh, yeah, and the rifle.
Hey, that, you know that rifle's that rifle?
Yeah. He's actually got one of the Nerf rifles over there. He's customizing for a simple project.
Yeah. So, they're pretty cool. I'm glad to actually have this one to put with my other Cobra Trooper. And then, just gonna go ahead and set him up here.
Just figured out how I could hold this
one. That's how I have my other one. Just do so, they look really good together. But, yeah, that's pretty much it for today's video. If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to leave a giant thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell notification so you know when we post a video.
Tickle, tickle.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram at everything.gijoe.
Crossfire X Collectibles.
And follow us on Facebook at HP Crossfire Collectibles.
And, so, I told you guys I had a little, thing to show you guys. So, there's speculation going on, you know, what's going to be in the next classified wave. We saw in the system, you know, Major Blood is listed as Asteroid. Target did have them in the system as 1999. Barbecue was in the system for 1999. Dr. Mindbender is in the system.
$39.99. Oh, wait, let's just redo that. But Dr. Mindbender...
is listed at $39.99. Now, the rumors were that a flight pod Trouble Bubble was going to be included with possibly Major Blood. Well, we see with the price difference between Major Blood and Dr. Mindbender, that's changed. Being as we have not yet seen Dr. Mindbender for the Classified series, we don't know if they're going to include it or not. I know they were having some issues with vehicles and blah, blah, blah. But, yeah, so we'll just have to wait and find out as to when that happens. Now, if you move on a little away from the Target Cobra Island Classified Everywhere stuff and go back to Walmart, and you have the Retro Collection. Now, people were starting to decipher, you know, these code names, you know, like Major Blood, for example, Asteroid. They also have the same names for their retro figures, which had the little code names. It could be like Mountain Lion or stuff like that. There were insects. There was like Scorpion. this popped up, and I actually took a picture of this so you guys can see it. But I found out what the next retro vehicle is. Like, Wave 1, you had the Hiss. Wave 2, you had the All-Striker, AWE Striker, whatever you want to call it. Wave 3, the Cobra Fang, which is finally starting to hit stores. I've been out the past 3 days and I haven't found anything. Like, Toy Hunt Tuesday sucked. Toy Hunt Wednesday was pretty good. And Toy Hunt Thursday, which was today, was pretty awesome.
Yeah, we found some good stuff. Today we actually picked up the Batman Beyond and some other stuff too.
I picked up some other stuff yesterday, stuff that's not in this video. Unfortunately, you're not going to see because we're not going to show some wrestling stuff, some Master of the Universe, like the Flocked Panther. But anyways, back to this subject. The fourth vehicle for the Retro Wave, believe it or not, take it as you will, is the G.I. Joe Vamp Mark II. Now, I actually took a picture of this, so I had it. I got the UPC number and stuff like that. Just remember, you might have heard it here first. I did think I seen a leaked picture of the box art. I mean, you know, it's pretty similar to the old vintage one, if not the same. But it's a little upgraded, especially with, you know, the figure in it.
But we're not lying about this.
It was blurry. It was blurry, that's all I can say. But now that's actual in the system, I saw the name and everything, so we know it's the Vamp Mark II, so it's cool.
And the Dr. Mindbender and all those we saw when we were at Target. I don't remember which Target it was.
This was a while ago, though.
Yeah, this was a while
ago. We were on
ago.
The hunt. I think we were hunting Vipers that morning.
I think it was Cobra Troopers.
You sure?
Yeah, it was before the Vipers.
No, it wasn't that long ago.
It was before
the
Vipers.
Firefly then.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it was either Firefly or Viper we were looking for. But the woman happened to be scrolling through the list. Oh, here's what's coming out. And I was like, oh, barbecue, I told you.
Yeah.
Rumors were barbecue. Well,
hopefully barbecue looks good. I have high hopes for him.
I just hope this helmet's not real, like, big and bulky.
I hope it, like, it is in
like
the
show.
Like
that PSA when he's like, talking like a robot. Anyways, that was funny. But yeah. So yeah, just wanted to give you a little heads up on some news about some of the G.I. Joe figures coming. As for the three figures that they're going to have, really am not sure.
Yeah.
But there's rumors it's going to be a Cobra Trooper, Officer, or Infantry. Flint is another rumor. Zartan is another rumor. But don't know yet. And I guess we won't find out until they're officially announced. Or, you know, whatever. But again, like he said, that'll do it for this video. And please click that like button. Tickle the bell. And we'll see you in the next one.
Peace.
Peace.